Today on Tactical Time, we're going to be learning how to train animals properly and also how to tame them somewhat. So we're very excited. We're in the safari today in Kenya, and so we got a lot of adventure ahead of us.
Calm down, buddy.
A good way to try and tame an animal is through their belly. Just like humans, the way to an animal's heart is through their belly. Your hat again. There we go.
Are you a fan of DC? You're funny. Ooh. I'm sorry, I'm married.
Wants a kiss.
He wants to kiss you.
A good way to get, you know, these horses aren't exactly wild animals, but they're not exactly domestic animals. So a good way to kind of tame them is you sing to them. So here I go. I'm calling to them. See, it works. I can just go ahead and pet them. They're not even gonna bite me. Yeah.
So, just caught this animal, and I'm gonna name him Freddy. And so, I'm working on getting him desensitized to me. Oh my goodness. It's so rough. and this is his friend.
Another type of feeding thing. We're gonna feed the animals with gas today because apparently they've been congested, so we need to get some fluid in them and kind of help them flush it out, you know, so this will help.
One of the best things to do when you're training animals is baby talk. You know, a lot of times, you know, they don't know what you're saying, but if you use baby talk, it just gets them, you know, really comfortable and excited, like, hi, little guy. Yeah, he's a good boy. He's a good boy. They just eat it up.
That was a good game of follow the leader.
Go fetch.
They did call him. Feel so popular.
It's like we're back in high school.
Yeah. Totally.
Come here, little blue-eyed guy. He's my favorite.
Gobblers. In front of them.
You mean a double chin?
Yeah, like a giant chin.
Let's see your impression of a double chin. What is wrong with that goat? Is it pregnant? Holy crap. So we got some alpacas here. They're my friends now. And I have named this one Michael, and this one, Jackson.
Michael Jackson.
Hello, Miss Squiggly. Okay,
so we found some rope, and we figured we could use it as a lasso to help us train the animals. So
and wrestle them.
Wrestle. So we're going to give it a shot here. Allie's up first. Giddy up. Oh, so close.
We're using a fake animal here, just for, you know,
practice.
Yeah.
Woo! Ye doggy.
Watch out for the horns. Got them. This would be a tame bull right now.
find that inner cowgirl.
It's just like toss the ring on the ball, you know?
It's just like that. Ho, ho! Ho! Wrestle, wrestle that thing.
Oh, its head almost popped off. That was maybe a little too aggressive on my part. You get the idea, though.
That is a tame bull.
Bow!
Whoa, that's abuse.
Alright, so another great way to just make the animals feel comfortable and, you know, so they're ready to train is to let them know that they're not the only one in the cage. So, for example, it works if you live in a cage for a few days, preferably just so they know that you're being real and not trying to trick them. So, I guess I'll see you guys in a few days. Do you want some? Do you want some?
Yeah.
Okay, here it comes. You ready?
You gotta be really careful when dealing with animals that can potentially bite and hurt or maim you. I find that it's best to show no fear because they can see it in your eyes. So you just gotta look at them and be like, bam, I'm not afraid of you.
What is a Z-donk?
It's half donkey, half zebra. Like the father is a zebra and the mother is a donkey. You're just a freak of nature, buddy.
Look.
Porcupines.
So cute. Oh, he just looked great.
Those are some big horns.
Just calm down. All right?
It's evil.
Ooh. Okay. You got a little something right there. Right. I just forget about it.
We have some emus. To me, they look just plain evil. I mean, they're very aggressive. Whenever they bite for the food, as you saw for Allie, they're just very aggressive and they're just evil. And let's get out of here.
This is like an alien llama that's antennas.
Its mother was a jackrabbit and its father was a llama.
We've captured these guys. Now these guys, they look kind of like some kind of rabbit mix, but they're actually large rodents. We found these guys in the sewers at our house, and so we just thought we'd put them in the cage and feed them. They're pretty happy, I think.
This is one of the animals that we've successfully been able to tame and train. His name is Casper, due to his white complexion. And you can see he's a lover and not a fighter.
Yeah.
And as you can tell, he loves the camera. I call him Herbie. These are Oriental frilled pigeons, and soon to be carrier pigeons, because we're going to train them to send messages, you know, across state borders and, you know, country borders, and we're just going to be breaking a lot of borders pretty soon with these guys.
We have just captured a very rare species of peacocks. It is an albino peacock. I think there's only 5 in the world, and we have managed to capture one.
What is it doing? It's freaking me out. That is the weirdest head I've ever seen in my life.
Doesn't that look like its brain is on the outside?
That would make a good Thanksgiving meal, though.
Don't see that right in front of him.
Oh yeah, I'm not supposed to taunt the animals. Here, turkey, turkey, turkey.
This is the what we learned portion of the video.
We have Hank here to help us out. So I learned that feeding animals can get pretty messy.
I learned that once you kind of tame animals, they're just really nice. Like this guy here. Most animals we've encountered today just really have a warm, you know, they welcomed us really warmly. So,
I learned that Z-Donk is a real animal and is not a myth.
There's also...
Oh, they're kissing. Oh. Animal love right here. Let's just take a second and learn a special lesson from these animals. Love, don't hate.
My heart is full. And this is also a mini zebu. We don't know what a zebu is, but it's probably a relative of the Z-Donk. So, and also, porcupines are nocturnal. That's what I learned. So
much.
Yeah.
That we learned.
Good educational trip.
Thanks for joining us today on
Tactical Time.